On the 6th of January 1912, German meteorologist Alfred Wegener first presented the Continental Drift hypothesis. Welcome to HistoryPod. Wegener's proposal to the German Geological Society defied the prevailing scientific understanding of his time. He dared to suggest that the continents were not fixed entities, but were instead drifting over the surface of the Earth. He argued that the continents were once connected in a single continuous landmass, now known as Pangaea, and had drifted apart since. At the heart of Wegener's theory were a series of distinct but related observations. Firstly, like many geographers and cartographers dating back as far as Abraham Ortelius in 1596, he noted the geometrical similarity between the coastlines of South America and Africa. He also highlighted the presence of identical fossils found on the two sides of the Atlantic, as well as similarities in rock formations. Wegener consequently hypothesized that together these pieces of evidence suggested that the continents had once been joined. Wegener's theory was met with scepticism, especially as he could not satisfactorily explain the mechanism by which the drift had occurred. He proposed that the centrifugal force of the Earth's rotation could be responsible, and also speculated that seafloor spreading, where new oceanic crust is formed at mid-ocean ridges, could have had a role to play. However, since he was a meteorologist rather than a geologist, his ideas were not taken seriously by his contemporaries. Nevertheless, Wegener's continental drift hypothesis laid the groundwork for the concept of plate tectonics, which became increasingly accepted from the 1950s. This has since become a unifying principle in modern geology, making continental drift instrumental in our understanding of the Earth's geological processes.